Electricity. It's hard to imagine life without it. Ever wonder, though, what exactly is electricity? How is it produced? How does it get to my toaster? Why is the sky blue? Where do babies come from? Okay, let's answer the first three questions. Electricity refers to an electric current or the flow of negatively charged electrons toward positive points. The stored up energy in a fuel source gets converted to an electric current at a power plant and then flows toward the other end of a closed circuit that powers your appliances, or lights up the night, or charges your phone so you can get back to texting. Electric power generation starts with an energy source. This may be a fossil fuel like coal, oil, or natural gas. It might be nuclear, like uranium. It might be a renewable source, such as solar, wind, or flowing water. It could even be garbage or agricultural waste. Coffee may be the fuel that gets you going in the morning, but it won't make electricity. Let's look at an example of a gas power system. The power generation process features two incredible high-tech machines, turbines and generators. Here, it's all about spinning, fast spinning. Whichever energy source is utilized, the object is to spin the blades of a turbine more than 3,000 times per minute. That generator has a large magnet surrounded by coils of copper wire. When the magnet rotates rapidly, the magnet's powerful magnetic field causes electrons to line up and flow in the generator's coils. A powerful magnetic field is created that lines up electrons around the coils and causes them to get moving. The rotating mechanical energy has thus been converted into electrical energy. Electricity! It's alive! Before the electric current is ready to venture out into the world, a transformer boosts it up to high voltage, reducing losses as it travels along the wires. This is similar to a city's water system, where pumps fill a water tower to increase pressure before it can be sent to all the neighborhoods. And no, these transformers don't turn into cars and fight giant alien robots. Now that the voltage has been boosted, high voltage lines carry it to substations on the power grid. The grid is the network of substations located around your nation. Since that high voltage is quite shocking, transformers at each substation are needed to bring the voltage back down to a level that can be used by big customers like factories and shopping malls. Power lines above ground and below then distribute the electricity to smaller local transformers that further reduce the voltage to 110 or 220 volts, a safe voltage for homes and businesses. Electricity typically enters your business or home through a meter that measures the amount of electricity you use. Once there, a distribution panel allows power to flow through wires in the walls to all the switches and outlets. And that's the amazing journey of electricity from the power plant to you. Got any more questions about powering the world? Ask GE Vernova. It's kind of our thing.